Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a tutorial on these fishtail braids. This is one of my absolute favorite ways to wear my hair when I'm wearing a hat. And I posted a picture forever ago on Instagram and so many people requested a tutorial and I don't know why I never did it. I just didn't. So I'm sorry, but here it is now. So I'm gonna be showing you the easiest way of all to do a fishtail braid. This can be a little bit intimidating. I know it looks like it's a lot harder to do than it actually is, but it is very simple. I'm gonna break it down on the easiest form for you guys today. So yes, my hair is pink today. I'm wearing a wig. Usually it's black, but today it's pink. I figured since my hair is basically black right now, it would be very hard to see exactly what I was doing when you have lighter colored hair. It's just kinda, I don't know. I feel like when I'm watching a hair tutorial, it's always easier to see what the person is doing on lighter hair. So because of that, I wanted to do a tutorial with you with my pink hair. If this is the first time you are on my channel, what's up and welcome. I would love for you guys to click the subscribe button down below and join my YouTube family. Also, make sure to click that cute little bell next to the subscribe button. That will notify you every single time I upload a video so you don't miss any of this fun stuff that happens here on this channel. And without further ado, we are going to get into this hair tutorial. And if you want to see how to get these cutie little fishtail braids, then just keep watching. So the first thing you'll do is split your hair down the middle like you would regular pigtails in two sections. You'll need a couple hair ties, and then we are just going to start on one side. So I'm gonna be splitting this one section into two halves, as you can see here. So what we're going to be doing is taking a small little piece of hair from the back of that section and crossing it over to the front section. And then from the front of the braid, I'm going to be taking this little section and crossing it to the back section. So when I'm referring to the front section, I'm talking about the one closest to my face, and the back section, I'm talking about the one towards the back of my head. The one tip to always keep in mind, if you're working with the back, you want to take a section of hair to cross over from the furthest point on the back of that section as you can. So just grab a piece as close to the back of your head as you can. Likewise, if you're working with the front section, you want to grab a piece of hair to cross over that is closest to your face. This is going to give it that real kind of like wrapped fishtail look. If you just take random sections, it's not going to take the shape that you want it to. So always keep that in mind. So you're going to use this technique on the entire braid. Nothing changes all the way down. I will let you know that it kind of takes a little while in the beginning for it to take its shape. So don't get frustrated if you don't start seeing it how you kind of envision it right away. Until you get a little ways down the braid, it just doesn't really feel like it's coming together right. I don't know why that is. This is kind of a tedious way to braid hair, but the end result is so stunning. I absolutely love it. So when I was first learning how to do this, I was watching a lot of tutorials and a lot of them sped up the process, which I didn't find very helpful. I feel like for me, I'm someone who's a very hands-on person and likes to see things in real time. So I'm kind of letting this play out in real time for you guys. I hope that's helpful, but I'm just gonna let you kind of watch the process here for a minute. So as I'm sure you've noticed, when I'm grabbing a piece of hair over from the other side, I'm taking it in with my pinky finger. That is just what feels the most natural to me. This is 100% not necessary. You'll find as you're doing this yourself, whatever way feels the best for you to grab the hair over. For me, when I'm holding both sections and taking another piece over, just grabbing it with my pinky feels the most natural and is the easiest for me. But again, it's totally not the right way. There is no right way. Just do whatever works for you. Once you've got your braid as long as you like it or as far as you can go, just grab yourself a little hair tie. Whatever kind you like to use will work. I personally like the thinner ones. You could even use some of the plastic ones, just whatever. Now that I have that on real tight, I'm just going to be pulling it down a little bit to give myself some slack to pull this braid out and kind of fluff it out a bit. I personally love big, thick, chunky fishtail braids. It didn't work so well with the wig. I feel like my natural hair's texture was not quite as silky or soft as this wig, so I get a little bit more volume and texture when I pull it apart. But this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you're a beginner, I hope this helped you out some. So
Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and check out my previous video, and I will see you guys in my next one.